For months, reports about pirates from Somalia hijacking cargo ships in the Gulf of Aden have dominated the news. Going unreported, however, are far more sinister activities taking place in the same waters, human smuggling. For years, Somalis and many Ethiopians have attempted to escape raging violence, displacement, disease, economic hardship, and hopelessness by paying smugglers in northern Somalia to ferry them to Yemen for the hope of a better life. As violence raged in Somalia throughout 2008, over 50,000 people attempted the perilous journey across the Gulf of Aden, risking their lives and, in many cases, the lives of their children, such as the desperation at home. Over 4 days in early December 2008, three teeming, overcrowded boats brought human cargo from Somalia. Among the roughly 500 people that made the journey, at least 28 perished. Many people were beaten brutally by the smugglers, who routinely throw the passengers overboard, often in the dead of night and far from shore, so as to avoid detection by the Yemeni Coast Guard. Several hundred people died attempting the journey in 2008. Untold others are missing, never having washed ashore. Andreas Koutipas is the field coordinator for the Doctors Without Borders Médecins Sans Frontières project on the southern coast of Yemen. His team provides medical services to those lucky enough to make it ashore alive.
I think it's a little bit strange how the world attention is focusing on the piracy issues when we have here an ongoing humanitarian tragedy. I mean, we have since the start of September, we had almost 7,000 people here and coming, and from these 7,000, we at least 300 drowned, and nobody knows about that. I mean, nobody gives any patient any attention, all the attention is focused on the pirates in the Gulf of Aden.
MSF maintains a network of local contacts along the coast, mostly village and tribal leaders, who alert the MSF team when new refugees and migrants come ashore. The team drives to the beach to provide emergency care to the exhausted and often traumatized survivors. They are then transferred to a United Nations reception facility in the town of Ahwar, where MSF operates a medical clinic and provides basic mental health services. New arrivals have often been through at least 2 or 3 days of mental and psychological terror, in addition to extreme physical distress from the cramped conditions on the boat.
The journey is a very tough journey. It's done in fishing boats, actually. These boats were constructed for fishing. It's 8-meter plastic fiberglass boats, and imagine 120 people in a boat of 8 meters. Also, the hulls of the boat are used for storing, putting people in, and unfortunately, we have many cases where people in the hull suffocate to death. The dead bodies are just thrown in the sea during the journey. And then we have the moment of the landing, which is the most dangerous one, because the smugglers are afraid to be caught by the local authorities. Then they force the people to disembark, sometimes in deep water. And this is because they want to be exposed near the shore as less as possible. The problem is that most of the people cannot swim. So even if the water is 3 meters deep, they still drown. We have had so many incidents when forced disembarkation was done by stabbing people. So we had to treat a lot of people with knife wounds, even women or children.
The high season for arrivals is between August and November due to favorable sea conditions. But even in the slower months, waves of people arrived in 2008, pushed from Somalia by the unrelenting violence or from Ethiopia by extreme poverty. In the first week of December, I was present when over 500 people arrived.
Just a quick head count, it seems approximately about 30 people, a mixture, mostly men, but some women. There's a clearly exhausted woman lying in a barren, rocky-strewn field, probably a couple kilometers from the sea, which I can see from here. I'm looking directly south to the Gulf of Aden. People have assembled along the road, so they've, after a two-day grueling journey in the sea, they walk a couple kilometers to the road and they wait. We get word that people have arrived, and we come out and provide them with basic essentials. Water is being distributed right now. Small plastic containers that you typically see in a deli in America, filled with dates. Foods that they are used to. High energy biscuits being distributed. people are desperately thirsty. They're immediately opening the bottles and drinking from them.
When this group arrived at the UN reception center in Ahwar, MSF medical staff examined them, and then they were finally able to rest. This man, who left his family in Mogadishu, says he paid $100 for passage from the northern Somali port city of Bosaso, where most of the smuggler boats launch into the Gulf of Aden. He said the smugglers beat him when he refused to jump into the water far from the Yemeni shore.
If it happened, you know, that I'm in Mogadishu again, I would prefer to stay in Mogadishu than traveling again by boat because I've seen the danger.
Some of the people who make the journey already know the risks. This mother of four had heard on the BBC about the dangers, about how so many die. Still, it was worth the risk.
We know that the journey is, and the boat is dangerous, but just we prefer not to stay in Somalia. It's better to die or to go. Whatever it has the journey, we used to hear in the radio BBC. And then we know a lot of problems about the journey, and then we prefer to die or to come in Yemen.
She said that she, her husband, and their children left Mogadishu because of the war, the fighting, the explosions. People are dying, she said, and there are no medical supplies in the hospitals.
She preferred to come in Yemen because she thought it's better here, because here it's safe, and in Somalia she cannot get a medical service and peace. And then she thought to come in Yemen and to get education for her children and the future, and to get a medical service and education and good future for her children. So she preferred to come in that dangerous boat.
Due to high levels of insecurity, MSF has had to pull out of some areas of Somalia and significantly reduce operations in other areas, including Mogadishu. The desperate measures that thousands of people are willing to take every year to escape testify to the horrors of life in that country. And as the violence and chaos increase, so do the numbers of those who arrive in Yemen, dead, alive, or somewhere in between.